Good morning and welcome to another segment of Beyond Boundaries, and I'm Shaniqua Fleming, and today I want to talk about something that I know everywhere we turn, everything we read, you know, just billboards, commercials, you know, everything that's in our world right now is probably starting to gear up for how do we create a better 2019. And, you know, I want to talk about this today because it's that time of year where it's the holiday season. And what I found over the years is that people tend to be a little bit harder on themselves, right, during this time of year. Depression stats go up. And I want us just to slow down a bit today to look at that. Let's talk about that. And I want to share with you some things that I do, as well as things that I recommend with my clients to help them kind of wind down the year without really creating this huge push for beating up on ourselves. That's the only way I can really think about it. You know, January, for whatever reason, has become known as the fairy godmother of new beginnings, even though 90% of the goals we set, many people don't accomplish them. And I think a part of that is because we're looking for this magical start in the first of the year. And what I found is that we haven't really stopped to really celebrate what we've done in the previous year. So I want to slow us down just a bit today. And I want to take you on a journey of how we can actually gear up for the next year by really celebrating what's right with 2018. So the first thing I want to talk about is, number one, let's take a moment and let's reflect on the year. I start this process for myself in about October. I start, you know, realizing what has worked really well for me. And this is not something that's just, you know, you can use it in your personal life, but this is something you can use in your professional lives. If you're a leader, if you're an entrepreneur, if you're a mom, if you're a dad, if you're a husband, if you're a wife, and even if you're a child that's watching this, because I know some children do tune in. Mine do anyway. So back to number one, reflecting on the year, figuring out what really worked well for you. What were those things that, you know, energized you? What were those things that, you know, gave you a boost when and kept you motivated to really continue to move about whatever that journey was you set out for yourself? The other thing about what energized you is realizing those things that, you know, new year, new me, we hear that, that's the slogan for many people, but what are those things that you're going to keep? So what are those things that will be anchors for you? What are those things that, you know, no matter what's changing and what you would like to change, you know that these will be staples in your life, in your routine, in your relationships, in your thoughts, in your practices, and just every aspect of who you are and how you want to go about the new year, if you will. So reflecting there. The other thing I like to think about is what drained you. So there's no need to continue to invest time, money, and energy in things that really didn't serve you. So figure out what those things are and those things were that drained you, and decide that you are going to do something different in those areas. Purge them from your life. You know, set boundaries if you need to. Or in fact, get honest with yourself and say, these are things that no longer serve me, and so I'm going to move in a different direction. The third thing that I like to recommend in terms of reflecting on the year is, what won't you change or do differently? That's one that, you know, is so important, because a lot of times we're changing everything. And I like to say that if we're making changes in every area and we're getting rid of everything and we're starting fresh, then we don't have what I call anchors, so that there is some familiarity, if you will, or something that makes you feel like it is worth it and you can see progress and you do know that things are moving in a direction that you want. So what are those things that you won't change? There's some relationships that really are critical. Continue to nurture those. There's some practices that you have that really have helped you to be consistent and be more in tune to who you are and what you want. Why change those? So in the reflection, think about those things that energize you, those things that drain you, and those things that you will not change. Okay? Well, the second thing I want to talk about is, and this is the perfect time because we just celebrated Thanksgiving, and in the month of November, it's known for this time of thanks, but I think it's important to give thanks every day, right? And that sounds so cliche-ish, but it really is important to give thanks, because typically when we show gratitude for things, the other things that we want or things that we're trying to attract, they come a little bit more naturally and easily to us because we're coming from a place of appreciation and gratitude. So say thank you and give thanks. Not just giving thanks for things in your life, but give thanks to people that have helped you. Give thanks to people that have supported you this year, and also give thanks to those people that may have taught you lessons that you didn't really want to learn. So just know that while those lessons may not have been ones we would have signed up for, we bless them and we bless the lessons, and we know that it was for our highest and our greatest good, and we move on so that we can focus on the things that we really want to multiply and expand in our lives. The third thing I want to talk about is, as we're planning for the new year, don't make it a duplicate or a carbon copy of this year, right? So if it's a new year, then there are some places and some things in our life that we need to start afresh, and we need to have be new as well. And stretch yourself, stretch beyond those goals that you know you can achieve. Once the mind has gotten a hold of new ideas and new concepts, it can't go back to what it once knew. I think it's Ralph Waldo Emerson that says something like that. So there I want to talk a little bit about setting new goals, stretching yourself beyond. If you've done it before, it's not a goal. It's just a target that you want to continue to maintain. So think about those things that you want to accomplish, those things that you want to see show up in your life. For me, I'm thinking about relationships that I want to nurture, and I want to grow and expand and be more fruitful in my life, and I want to be more fruitful in their lives. And so that's a really big one for me, because relationships are critical for me. So think about those areas where you want to stretch and you want to grow, and how you want to really make 2019 a different year. I saw this meme on social media, and it said, in 2019, I'm going to work on the goals that I set on 2018 that I really wanted to accomplish in 2017. I got really distracted in 2016, but I really set out to do them in 2015. So it just kind of sounds like it was the same, you know, repetitive nature of not doing anything. And so if we're really going to do something, we've got to start somewhere. And it doesn't need to be this big step, right? Just take small steps, make commitments, and when you decide those things that are important to you and that are valuable to you and, you know, that really matter in your life, then oftentimes you never have to make a decision. You just stick with your commitments. So decide what it is that you want in 2019, make a commitment, be intentional, and take action. All right, so the fourth thing I want to talk about, and this is a really good one. I brought my notes today because I didn't want to forget these, and sometimes I get so excited about some of the points that we're talking about on the show that I get a little bit off track. So I wanted to make sure I didn't forget. The fourth one, and this is one that, this is probably my favorite one, and this is where we really begin to slow down, reflect, appreciate ourselves, other people, so incorporating all those things that I just talked about, so that we can recharge our mind, our body, and our spirit. So personally, I spend like the last couple weeks of the year doing this, and I get it. Everybody's not able, or everyone may not be ready to invest the last 2 weeks of the year to really recharge and rejuvenate your mind, your body, and your spirit. I wasn't always there either. And it doesn't mean that you have to, you know, just tune yourself out from the world and your family and everyone for 2 whole weeks, but really making a conscious effort to slow down and think about and recharge yourself, you know, those last couple of weeks. Here's the thing. If you didn't do it the other 50 weeks in the year, those last 2 weeks aren't going to make that big of a difference in terms of what you really want to get done before the start of the new year. So take that time, re-energize yourself. And what you'll find is sometimes we have to go slow to go fast. So when we slow down, we give ourselves an opportunity to breathe. We give ourselves an opportunity to appreciate that which we've already done. And that gives us the energy to really move forward and propel us to the next levels that we're interested in seeing in our lives. Anyway, so that being said, you know, slow down. Write down your successes. Before you even start to really set those goals, What did you accomplish this year? What are you most proud of? What is something that you helped someone else do? What's something that you can appreciate that you saw other people doing that maybe, you know, they don't even realize how important their contributions were even to your world? So say thank you. Again, going back to thank you. Thank them for that. Celebrate that. Revitalize your mind, your body, and your spirit. You know, spend some time in meditation. Spend some time in prayer. You know, really reminding yourself as to what your gifts are and why you do what you do and why you're so thankful that you're able to do what you do. There are many people that aren't aware of who they are or why they can do the things they do. They're not even in their right mind. So take this time to really just slow down and celebrate who you are and the gifts that you have and just allow yourself to breathe. Speaking of which, I'm really excited and I want to share with you because I am thankful for everyone that has tuned into Beyond Boundaries this year. This was something that I set out at the beginning of the year to do. And I'll be honest with you, it's been a growth process because every single month as we came on and we brought topics to you and we brought guests on the show, it was me pushing beyond my comfort zone. I think I started out the year telling, or maybe I didn't tell you this, but I'll tell you now, I never wanted to be on camera. In fact, it was something that I was just dreadful about because it just felt unnatural to me. And I pushed myself to do this because I knew that in order for me to really get the message out everywhere that I wanted to be, I had to start somewhere. So I had to start on Good Morning Miramar if I'm ever gonna get to Good Morning America, right? Right. So there's my point. Small steps make big impact. So I'm thankful for you for tuning in. And as I'm celebrating this year and I'm thinking about next year, I'm celebrating the fact that I did 12 months of this show when there were some months when I didn't know if I would have the courage to come back on. And I did. And I thank you for the messages you sent me, the inbox messages, the topics that you told me you wanted to hear about. And so I invite you to do that again as we gear up for next year. I also want to celebrate the fact that for this year, I started a conversation in South Florida with leaders, and it's called Leaders Who Lunch. And each quarter, it was a quarterly conversation, and each quarter we came together and we talked about really bold and audacious topics that many people are thinking about in their organizations or in their businesses or in the work environment, but there's not quite the conversation about it. So we talked about ageless, fearless, genderless leadership. We talked about power and influence. We talked about, you know, going beyond the walls of leadership and really tapping into who people are and sharing who you are and being vulnerable as a leader. And this December, you know, ladies have been asking, how can we have topics that are really relevant for us? And I do believe it takes an integration of all in order for us to move the needle of progression, if you will, in this thing called leadership. So I don't segregate. I bring men and women together because I believe that we all need to be in the conversation. That being said, I decided that December will be a special edition, ladies only edition of Leaders Who Lunch. And so I think this is important because as women, we often give, and this whole part of revitalizing ourselves, we can sometimes fall off our own priority list, if you will. So this December, December 7th, for the Leaders Who Lunch conversation, we will be having lunch and conversation at one of my favorite spas in Miami. So if you want more information about that, you know, tune into my social media handles, or it's also on LinkedIn, or send me a message and I'll send you the link so that you can register for it. The great thing about it is not only will we have lunch, I am gifting every person that comes an opportunity to enjoy a spa experience. So it's gonna be about $75 worth of spa services, and that will be my gift to each of my participants for the lunch. So I thank you in advance for those of you that are coming. And again, I thank you for tuning in. Again, these are just four things that I think are really important as you are winding down the year and you're gearing up for next year. You don't really stop, but you do pause a bit to reflect and celebrate and appreciate and give thanks and revitalize and rejuvenate, because that's really what the secret sauce is to making next year an even better year. So until next month, thank you for tuning in to another segment of Beyond Boundaries. I'm Shaniqua Fleming, and I look forward to continuing to hear from you, and have a great rest of the day.